In this video, we are going to talk about the for loop. This counter is increased within a for loop. Basically, a for loop is used to start at a certain value and count until another value is reached. And in this video, we are going to find out how to do that. So please click on the little icon here or press F4 on your keyboard. And now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here we want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleForLoop. Now I click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Let's delete everything above the OnTick function and the two command lines here. First we need to create a start value. I will call this one counter. It's an integer variable, and in the initialization we will assign the value 1 here. Let's also create an end value. In our case, we want the counter to count until the value 10,000 is reached, and inside of the onTick function we are going to use the for loop. It has 3 expressions. If you have never seen a for loop before, it might look a little bit weird, but it's not so hard to understand. The first parameter here is the starting value. That's our counter. In our case, the counter is 1. The second parameter is the expression that should be checked. So, if the condition counter is below end value is true, the loop will continue. And the third parameter here is what should happen after this condition has been checked. In our case, we are going to increase the counter by 1. Counter plus plus means that we take the current value of the counter and at 1, we could also use this kind of expression. And within two curly braces, we want to do something. In our case, we use the print statement to output the words the counter equals and the current value of the counter. So let's compile the code. And if you don't see any errors here, you can click on the little symbol here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader we want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or we could press Ctrl and R. Here we pick the new file simpleforloop.ex4. Please enable the visualization here and start a test. And now we see that our counter is working. It's counting up until it reaches 9999, and the for loop is also able to count down. So actually we could switch the values here. Now the starting value of our counter is 10,000, the end value is 1, and this time we want to count down from the counter value 10,000 as long as the counter is bigger than the end value. And we want to subtract 1 for each time we count. So let's recompile the code, go back to MetaTrader and start a new test. And this time we have a countdown. The counter will be diminished until this condition is no longer true. Our end value is 1. That's why the last entry here says that counter equals 2. We could also use the expression is greater or equals end value. Now recompile, start a new test, and this time it should say the last counter equals 1. What's interesting is that we could also take other values here. For example, we could diminish the counter by 10. Let's recompile that one, and this time our counter will be diminished by the factor 10. And now you know how to use a for loop, a counter and an end value to count upwards or downwards, and you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL4 code.